This is why you have to start dropshipping within the next couple of weeks, even if you don't have the experience. What's up, guys, and welcome to a brand new video. My name is Patrick Nielsen, aka Paddy here, and aka Paddy here on social media. If you're brand new to the channel, I do e-commerce, dropshipping in particular, meaning that I don't have the products that I sell in the storage. My suppliers send it directly to the customer. Now, this video is something that I should maybe have done last month. This is simply just about, as you can see down in the title, why you should start dropshipping now, like right now. I'm pretty sure a lot of you guys have heard that Q4 is late, Q4 is this, Q4 is that, have to get going. But I'm also pretty sure that 95% of you guys out there haven't really done anything about it. It can be because you don't really, it's not gonna happen for me, or Q4 is not that powerful. The biggest mistake you will ever do is not start now, but start in January or February, when you feel like you're a bit more comfortable with your money. Trust me, it is literally 3 to 4 times easier to sell right now than it will be in 2 months, meaning that you'll get way more bang for the buck. Meaning that if you are on a budget, you have to start now. Let's turn around for no reason and talk more about it. So, let's actually talk about the reasons why Q4 is so much more profitable. Well, the biggest dominator, of course, it's Christmas. One day where we all have in common that we have to go out and buy presents. So that alone, Christmas alone, buying presents, gifts, everything around that. And you also know that, well, for most people, Christmas starts from the 1st of December. You can buy so many decorations for the house. But besides that, we have Halloween. That is over now, obviously. Doesn't matter, and the most money are yet to be made. But besides Halloween, we have something called Thanksgiving. People also buy a lot there. And the magic things about Thanksgiving is around that time, we have Black Friday and we have Cyber Monday. So from Friday to Monday, that full weekend there with Monday, you're gonna make more money than any other point of the year, pretty much. Honestly, it's insane. So those are the big driving forces. And you also have to remember, every single year, the overall revenue of e-commerce sales are going like this. So alone, every single year, like next Q4, that's gonna be made more money than this year. Next Q4 after that, that's gonna be made more money after this year. If everything goes as it goes now. Plus, people just buy more. So everything's just perfect. So imagine this. So you have a product, right? Let's say it's these fake AirPods. Actually pretty damn great. You are gonna go out there, make a beautiful brand store about these, one product store I will presume. Great ads, just decent ads actually. You're gonna put this out in February. You might, you know, maybe gonna be profitable or break even. Or if everything goes well, you'll have a decent store. Put them out now, you're gonna be profitable from day one. And imagine a lot of you guys out there are on a budget. Let's say you have $200 to play with, and you put $50 into marketing today, and you're gonna make, let's say, $100, $150 back. Compared to February, you put 50 in, you might get around 50 back. These are just numbers I'm throwing out there, but it's just to tell you that it's so much easier to get return on ad spend, return on investment right now, because people just buy more. It's that simple, like it's in black and white, people buy more. And that's why it's super, super important that you get into it now, even though you don't have the biggest experience, because trust me, you will get more out of it doing some quick research, good now that buying a course, buying a mentorship, whatever you do, and learn the basics as fast as possible, and be at a very amateur level and go out there and sell, then learning now for a couple months, beginning January, February of 2020, and now you know enough, like you actually know a lot about everything, you pretty much know everything. Trust me, you're gonna be more successful right now, because you also learn a lot once you're in the process. Plus, you just make, it's just so easier to sell. That's why I'm trying to get out there. Now, having said all of that, if you have zero experience at all, of course. You're not just gonna try to install a product like that and sell it. Because at the end of the day, you're still gonna sell something, and you can't sell a shitty product on a shitty store. But what I recommend you to do is use me and my other colleagues here on YouTube. Watch through all of my YouTube videos. Watch through all of my colleagues' YouTube videos. Just search out that. How to do proper research, product research. How to set up a store, how to set up a branded store. How to make it an ad, how to make a campaign, how to make ad copy. Go with that and do so much research that it's gonna bore you, honestly. You have to have the mentality that you want to learn as much as anybody have ever known about dropshipping. Now, if I was you to speed up the process, because again, every single day that passes on, you waste revenue and money. So what I would do, I would go out there, if it's me, if my colleague, if it's your friend who know how to dropship, I don't care. Go out there, ask them. If they don't already have a mentorship, if they have a mentorship, see if everything works, price range, with your budget and everything works. I would go with that, because that's why you're learning the most in the shortest amount of time. Let's go with that. Hey man, what do I need to pay you to know all of your skills? Because trust me, every mentor that you get to, if it's a real one, of course, what they price the mentorship for is nothing compared to all the money they have spent in, for example, product research, stores, Facebook ads to learn and accumulate their skills. So it's every single penny worth if you go to the proper guy. My idea with this is that go out there and get a course, a mentorship, whatever. What I'm trying to say is that within the next 2 days, you can just bang on, focus on that course or that mentorship. And within two days to a week or so, you know what you need to know to get started, because you just want a store out there. So here's what I do when it comes to Q4. That Q4 is my time where I just set up stores so they are set up for the next year. Meaning, I'll set up a business right now.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine, and you're not really fine, but you just can't get it.
Selling these bad boys. Set it up now, build the flow, build a ton of sales and data, so that when we come into 2020 and go a little bit down before they're gonna go up again, well, I have tons of data. I can now make, honestly, real, real good lookalike artists. I can make retargeting. I have so much data and I got sales, so I can just ride the flow while growing a little bit. And then when it comes to Q4, boom, I can grow even more. But it's so much harder to get off the grid and kind of like grow. You can, of course, you can do it, but it's like if you want to start a store in the beginning of the year, Q2, Q3, whatever it is, but you will never have the momentum from day one as you will here in Q4. So that's just what I'm trying to tell you. You don't have to go on that focus on building a six-figure business, seven-figure store, whatever. Four-figure store, five-figure store, start somewhere. It's only because of Q4 that I really accumulated success and then could grow from there and be where I am today. Because the product that I sold at that point wasn't really a winning product. It was just a decent product. There was some general trend around it, but it wasn't massive. And it wasn't like a product where I just made 5,000 a day. No, I got it to around 1,000 a day. And it coasted around there for a couple of weeks to 3 weeks, a month. Well, actually 2 months before it kind of like went down a hill. But at that point, I've accumulated sales, revenue, success. So with that, I built a new store, could test way more products. Actually had a job for myself, where I wouldn't have been able to have that if I waited to January or February. So I'm strictly and honestly talking from my experience, and that's why I want to put this video on right now, because it's not too late. Yes, it is the 7th of November and we're getting there, like we are halfway in a week or so, but it's definitely not too late. Like in November for me is where I make the most money, because of course as you're dropshipping, when you come to, for example, Christmas presents, you have to stop that around Black Friday, you can maybe push it the week in for December, but then you have to stop it, because or else your orders, and which are Christmas presents, a lot of them won't make it to Christmas Day. And trust me, you'll get a whirlwind of angry customers if they don't get their presents and orders products on Christmas Day. So that's my 2 cents for this video. Don't compare yourself to anybody else. Just make sure that you learn something new every single day and that you get better and that you make a plan for the actions that you're about to do. If you need any more help with anything, go down the description. You can find me on Instagram. You can DM me there with any questions that you might have. I would gladly help you out. If you found this video very helpful, or just helpful at least, go down and subscribe. That would mean the world to me. Like, comment, share, do whatever you need or do whatever you want to. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.